Hey everyone, welcome back to Chipstock Investor. Today we're going to be focusing on Synopsys, the EDA software provider, and we'll be talking about their most recent updates, their merger with ANSYS, and the letter that they received from the Bureau of Industry and Security. Synopsys is an EDA and IP provider to basically the entire electronics industry. It's a foundational company providing design automation software and patents.
If you missed it, back in January, Kasey and I did a deep dive on the EDA oligopoly, Synopsys, Cadence Design Systems, and Siemens EDA, which was an acquisition of the old EDA software company, Mentor Graphics. Synopsys, the leader in EDA, enables every single semiconductor end market there is. Now, the driver of growth this last few years, especially, has been NVIDIA and the accelerated computing and AI infrastructure boom that they've kicked off. We're still waiting for the other major end markets to really kick into high gear, especially the big global automotive and industrial market. In recent earnings updates from TSMC, Synopsys is essentially, think of them as an on-ramp to companies that have designed chips and then they're ready to manufacture them with a key partner like TSMC. Indications are that that big automotive and industrial segment, enterprise, excluding AI, are all getting ready to heat up the second half of this year. So back in January, we outlined some of the reasons we were feeling a bit more optimistic about Synopsys and Cadence Design Systems. But a lot has changed in the last 5 months. So let's get to it. The reasons why Synopsys and ANSYS want to merge in the first place and some of the things they've agreed to divest to make this deal go through. The expectation is within the next few weeks, sometime in June of 2025.
As we mentioned at the outset, Synopsys is a electronic design automation company. They provide the software from silicon to systems. You can see them on the left. ANSYS is more of a physics simulation software, seeing how things will work before they actually have to send them to the manufacturing line. So melding these companies together will provide a full stack software company. And here's some of the long-term objectives that Synopsys and ANSYS think that they can obtain: revenue, double-digit growth year over year. They also expect that they can increase their margin growth, with the expectation being in the mid 40% range, and then free cash flow margins in the mid 30% range. So very good combined growth for these companies. We'll talk a little bit more about some of those things that ANSYS and Synopsys have done to get that merger across the finish line. But let's key in on this letter from the Bureau of Industry and Securities that Synopsys received and how this affects not just Synopsys, but the entire EDA oligopoly, Cadence, Siemens, and ANSYS.
Last week, we had a Synopsys earnings update, Q2 of their fiscal 2025. The 3 months ended in April, and it was addressed immediately on the call that they had not received this letter from the U.S. Department of Commerce, the division of that being BIS, Bureau of Industry and Security. But then the very next day, they did receive the letter, and they basically wiped the rest of their fiscal year guidance off the table because they got this letter that said cease and desist from selling software. Actually, we don't know exactly what they were told to stop selling, but we can assume it's all sales from software to the IP that works with the software itself. Stop selling that to China. And so what does that mean for Synopsys? As of Q2 of the fiscal year, China was about 10% of revenue. So let's just assume that number is going away. Not great news, but not devastating news either, because the outlook that had been given prior last year was that actually China revenue was going to be somewhere in the mid to high single digits as a percentage of revenue as we exit fiscal year 2025. Again, not ideal, not a great situation, but not catastrophic either. Because as China's revenue has decreased from the large backlog of orders China needed post-pandemic, other geographies have more than made up for that. Europe is up, Korea is up, other, which includes Taiwan, as a percentage of revenue, also on the rise in North America. The largest customer there is, of course, Intel. Synopsys has counted Intel as its largest customer for a long time. Intel's struggles are well documented, but the rest of the world more than making up for Intel and this kind of slow reduction in the China revenue.
Something similar is happening with ANSYS. Revenue from China, just 8.5%, down from 10% the same quarter last year. Here's Cadence Design Systems just for reference. Here's the China revenue we have highlighted. 2024, 12% for the full year. And in Q1 2025, down to 11% of revenue.
We can assume this is similar for Siemens EDA, even though they don't provide a specific geographic breakdown for their EDA segment. Remember to check out Semi Insider. We actually did a recent high-level overview of Siemens business just last month. But let's just quickly pivot back here. This is the Synopsys full-year fiscal 2025 revenue and profit guidance that they reaffirmed last week and then promptly said, actually, scratch that. This is no longer valid after getting that letter from the BIS. What we're penciling in at this point is just based on the loss of the revenue end of May, beginning of June 2025, roughly a little over halfway through the fiscal year, we're just going to say this guidance just scratch about 5% off of the revenue, the earnings per share, and the free cash flow for fiscal year 2025 as a result of being restricted from selling to China. Kasey, let's take a look at the EDA software industry. A lot of consolidation has happened, especially in the last year or two. A lot of companies, including Cadence, making some acquisitions after Synopsys and ANSYS announced their merger. But there are still some companies of note here, including a new one.
That company over on the right side of this slide, Empyrean. This company trades on the Shanghai Stock Exchange, number 301269. This company is a tiny EDA provider, state-owned and controlled by China, that could possibly see a bump in sales due to the EDA cease and desist letter from BIS. Empyrean was placed on the U.S. entity list or a no-trade list in December, but it doesn't mean that investors can't buy the stock.
Quick high level, Empyrean on track to do something in the ballpark of 120 to 130 million on an annual run rate basis in sales this year. So very tiny company. Not saying you should go out and buy that stock, just something that we have taken note of over on Semi Insider, and we'll be monitoring the situation as things unfold with this pending merger between Synopsys and ANSYS. Speaking of this letter to cease and desist selling to China for Synopsys and ANSYS too, we can assume, we're unclear what exactly this means for the pending merger, but it is possible it's a good thing. So all regulatory authorities have signed off on the deal, except for China's SAMR, the State Administration for Market Regulation. So if Synopsys and ANSYS are no longer deriving any revenue whatsoever from China, the deal is possible. It can now simply go through as promised, minus, of course, the China sales from Synopsys and ANSYS. We'll take a look at this, and of course, we'll have updates as we get more information, but that's what we're thinking at this particular junction here. Maybe Synopsys and ANSYS really can finish the merger this month in June 2025.
We discussed some of these proposed divestitures back in January that Synopsys and ANSYS have made to get regulatory approval everywhere else. Now, none of these include the SIG sale or the company now known as Black Duck Software, which was completed in October. Synopsys entered into an agreement with Keysight to sell their optical solutions group. ANSYS also has an optics software or physics software for optics. And Keysight already also has an optics and photonics section, so it was a good fit for Keysight to take over that segment from Synopsys.
And then the most recent one, ANSYS and Synopsys agreed they would also sell to Keysight ANSYS Power Artist, which helps engineers solve for different power problems within a chip system. So not just the chip itself and then figuring out what type of power requirements are needed, but working backwards from the power needs itself. Again, something that Synopsys has. So divesting the ANSYS portion to Kasey preserves some semblance of competitiveness for customers that are in need of choice. Maybe they don't want to use just Synopsys plus ANSYS. So you still have Kasey.
Let's focus on the financials of Synopsys. Where are we at right now? With or without the China business, Synopsys is still in free cash flow cycle trough. ANSYS is a little bit of a different story. They have a different business model. Growth is a bit slower for them, but more steady. And this is driven by the more diversified end markets that ANSYS participates in.
And of course, thanks to our friends over at finchat.io for providing these visuals. Fantastic research platform that we make use of every single day when we're doing our deep dives into industries and businesses that participate in those industries. Check it out. Our link in the description below gets you 15% off your own subscription.
Ultimately, when you're looking at Synopsys, it's not all doom and gloom. It's better to zoom out and look at how they've actually performed over the past couple years, especially when most of the other end markets have been in a very significant downturn.
Along the way, the last couple of years during this downturn, Synopsys has continued to grow its revenue. And eventually, we still have the expectation that the free cash flow down cycle will turn upwards again. And that could end up being a 2 to 3 year cycle. And you don't want to miss the beginning of those cycles because the first wave of growth tends to be quite dramatic. So the EDA leaders, Synopsys, Cadence, Siemens EDA, perhaps even Kasey, still waiting for the return of growth for the industry, excluding AI and accelerated computing. If you remove NVIDIA and TSMC, everybody else still waiting for a more dramatic upturn. And that would, of course, be excellent news for Synopsys. We do need to subtract, I think, roughly 5% from the forecast for Synopsys for the remainder of this year. But while that may not be the best news ever, we think this is a manageable situation. And perhaps this is just simply some sort of bargaining chip as we wait for Trump and Xi to get together and iron out some sort of trade deal between the US and China.
Thanks everybody for watching. That's a wrap on this video for Synopsys. Check out Semiconductor Insider. You can get access to our Discord server with all of our research. Link in the video description below, and we will see you later here at Chipstock Investor.